नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब, खम्मा गणी और राम राम सा। वर्कमॉप द्वारा शुरू की गई कहानियों की इस खास मुहिम में आज हम मिलेंगे आस्था दीक्षित से और जानेंगे इनकी लाइफ की इस खूबसूरत जर्नी के बारे में। दोस्तों, आस्था दीक्षित एक एक्ट्रेस, ऑथर, क्लासिकल डांसर एंड कोरियोग्राफर है। वर्तमान में ये अपने हस्बैंड एंड इन लॉज के साथ फ्लोरिडा US में रह रही है। दोस्तों, आस्था दीक्षित इंडिया से US तक की अपने इस जर्नी से जुड़े कई किस्सों और अनुभवों को आज हम सभी के साथ साझा करने वाली है, लेकिन उससे पहले हम इनसे जुड़ी कुछ खास जानकारी आप सभी के साथ साझा करना चाहते हैं। जी हां, आपको बता दें, नई दिल्ली में जन्मी आस्था दीक्षित लॉस एंजलिस कैलिफोर्निया में पली पड़ी। इन्होंने द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ कैलिफोर्निया लॉस एंजलिस से कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर के रूप में स्नातक की उपाधि प्राप्त की। जी हाँ, इंजीनियरिंग कंप्लीट करने के बाद इन्होंने इस फील्ड में आगे बढ़ने के लिए काम करना प्रारंभ किया, लेकिन ये दिल से इस काम के साथ नहीं जुड़ सकी क्योंकि इन्हें सुकून मिलता था डांस करने में। जी हाँ दोस्तों, नृत्य को अपनी आत्मा में बसाने वाली आस्था दीक्षित ने नृत्य में अपने इस जुनून को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए अपने कॉर्पोरेट करियर को पीछे छोड़ दिया। इन्होंने कथक में अपने गुरु से प्रॉपर ट्रेनिंग ली और फिर अपनी खुद की डांस कंपनी स्थापित की। अपनी डांस की जर्नी को आगे बढ़ाते हुए इन्होंने दुनिया भर में दौरा किया, कई स्टेज परफॉर्मेंसेस दी और इस दौरान ये ना सिर्फ एक अच्छी डांसर बल्कि एक बेहतरीन परफॉर्मर के रूप में उभर कर सभी के सामने आए। दोस्तों, ये तो हुई इनके डांस की जर्नी की बात। आपको बता दें, ये मल्टी टैलेंटेड शख्स हैं। डांस के अलावा इन्होंने अपने बेहतरीन अभिनय से भी लोगों का खूब दिल जीता है। वहीं ये एक लेखिका के रूप में भी अपनी पहचान बनाने में सफल हुई है। जी हाँ, हाल ही में डोर टू हेवन नाम से इन्होंने अपनी बुक पब्लिश की है। अपने जीवन की अद्भुत और अविस्मरणीय यात्रा को इन्होंने अपनी बुक के माध्यम से जन जन तक पहुंचाने का प्रयास किया है और ये काफी हद तक अपने इस प्रयास में सफल हुई है क्योंकि लोगों को बहुत अच्छा रेस्पॉन्स इन्हें मिला है। दोस्तों, आस्था दीक्षित ने एक एक्ट्रेस, ऑथर एंड क्लासिकल डांसर के रूप में लोगों में अपनी एक अमिट छाप छोड़ी है और खुद को हर मुकाम पर, हर क्षेत्र में बेहतर साबित किया है। तो अपनी सफलता की इसी यात्रा से जुड़े मजेदार किस्सों और अनुभवों को आप सभी के साथ साझा करने के लिए ये आई है आज। तो चलिए दोस्तों, मिलते हैं इनसे और जानते हैं इनकी इस खूबसूरत और प्रेरक जीवन यात्रा के बारे में।
I am Asa Dikshit. I'm an actor, dancer, choreographer, and I'm currently residing in the US, but I used to live in India. And I have recently just published my book, Door to Heaven, which is the journey of my life. And the journey has been from India to US, back to India, and then back to US. I have my parents that are living in India, and my brother as well is in India. And currently I'm living in Florida, USA, with my husband and his family. And that's where we are here right now, in sunny Florida. I was born in New Delhi. But as a young kid, we moved to Los Angeles. So my schooling was entirely in Los Angeles, where I grew up, and I studied from UCLA, which is one of the finest prestigious universities, and in computer engineering, and it was the toughest. And then that led me on to moving back to India, where I decided to, and I started getting recognized for something totally different, which was my profession as a dancer and an actor. And I went into the movies, I went into dance professionally, I studied with my gurus in Kathak, and I trained extensively, and after the training, I started touring on my own. I worked in various countries as well. I worked in the Middle East and toured around the world globally with my own dance company. So Kathak having different schools or gharanas, I actually was privileged to dance in both gharanas, and my gurus were from the Kathakendra Institute, which is in New Delhi. And that really gave me the wings and the ability to really choreograph and capture my audience, having studied in the different styles of Kathak and having understood the nuances and the footwork and the pirouettes and all the various aspects that go into the dance choreography and the dance performance. And that led me to being a worldwide global performer, where I had the opportunity to perform on so many stages. I have had many struggles. For one, I never felt like I really belonged anywhere in any country, whether I was in the US or in India, 100%. I always had a different perspective, and many times people related to that, and sometimes they didn't. I had a personal struggle, various challenges in my personal journey during my performance years, and sometimes that reflected in my performances. But that eventually changed, and my performances grew through them. This is all explained in my book, that therefore I will not elaborate on it in detail. And I have my book right here. But there is a chapter called In Search of Love, and that really talks about the personal struggles and how my work grew through them. I really share my personal struggles in the book only for the purpose of motivating others. To leave my profession behind, having graduated with such high magna cum laude distinction in my college, and having such a career as a computer engineer, and having a profession that really gives back so much, you know, and leaving all those comforts behind, that was the toughest call, to choose my passion over my profession in a way, and a new profession, making a new identity through my dance, through my acting, through my presence on screen and on stage. That really kind of, that expression became my identity over time. I have many role models. In dancing, it's so-and-so. In acting, it's so-and-so. And so-and-so people have inspired me on my personal growth journey. But however, it's hard for me to say any particular name, because there's so many role models out there and so many wonderful examples. But I've been a role model in myself, because I've lived multiple lives in one, and wearing so many different hats, living in different countries. As I mentioned, I was a computer engineer, but I chose to go on a different route. I toured globally in various countries in the Middle East and all over the world. I starred in two films in the cinema in India, and I also got recognized for various things along the way. So, having done so many stage performances and various platforms, so I've been recognized and I've done so many various things. I think that it's important to have role models, and I follow and keep up with so many wonderful examples out there, but it's really hard for me to say one particular name. The quote I'm going to say is, "What you seek, seeks you." It's by Rumi. Sorry, I'm going to take that again. "What you seek is seeking you," by the great poet Rumi. Taking me for an example, in my life, my dreams have always happened, given that I dreamt them clearly and I was determined. And when I sought something else, that too happened, as long as I was determined. So what you seek is seeking you. For the achievements is my TED Talk, which I gave in Gujarat, and it was organized by an international school, and the kids of the TED-Ed Club organized the whole thing. It was very well put together, and the speakers were fantastic. And I really enjoyed talking about my passion. And of course, the dance performance was the best part. I think my dance performances themselves and each are an achievement, as each and every one of them, we spend so much time putting together our best performance and putting our best foot forward to make it spectacular, you know, experience for everyone. And each time we get rewarded with so much respect. So I think they themselves are memories, each one to be, you know, to be celebrated. As well as, I think I deserve equal credit for my acting. I've starred in two full-length feature films in the industry, that is Pelaina Kutalo and Chandrahas. I'm sorry if I'm saying that incorrectly, but that really was appreciated, and it was very memorable for the entire industry. And I unfortunately couldn't spend more time in the films because of my hectic dance schedule and because of another journey, which is explained in my book. And by far the biggest achievement has been so far my book that has really fulfilled my life's journey. And it is published now on Amazon and on various platforms. And this is really, I've written many articles as well. And one of them is published in Times of India. Definitely my experience is more valuable. The education has given me confidence and the wings to do what I did. But had it not been for the experience, I would be nobody today and I wouldn't be able to share my story with the world. My only advice is if you do something, do it fully. That is the only thing I have followed. So many people will tell you so many things, but all I can say is that everything else will follow if you do something wholeheartedly. My childhood memories are in this beautiful house in New Delhi, and I was living with my parents and my grandparents, and I was very naughty. rightfully so. And I, in very simple, small things, I have memories of me, doing simple, nut cut, naughty little pranks around the house, like stealing like the food and eating the cabbage as the food was being prepared for the cooking and all. And I remember that I used to dance at the age of 3, is as early as I can remember, in front of the TV while my parents were watching Chitrahar. And I would, they would not be able to see what's on TV. They could only see my, their daughter dancing and choreographing all the movements. And so these are my childhood memories. So as you can see, that the talent is apparent from a very young age. And I think many times people struggle to find their purpose in life and what they should be doing, why they are here. And they have all these big questions. And I think that it's the simplest answer. Sometimes it's the toughest, but for me it was dance. The pandemic really taught us a lot of things that, first of all, allowed us to step back, slow down in life, and perhaps to spend more time with our loved ones. And so many grievances and so many losses during this time, I think, unfortunately, we had to face, and we are still facing. But I think all in all, it integrated us into ourselves as human beings and gave us that time in the universe to do that, because there is no time otherwise, as the things are moving so fast. And from what I see, people have really grown from this time, and it's had a positive impact on many people. And also it's allowed us to integrate technology into our lives, which is like unparalleled, which is unlike we've ever seen before. Like we are doing now, it's, we're able to just cross, do so much with the use of technology. So yes, the technology has allowed us to reach each other across the boundaries without having to go and meet each other. But I think the real value has been in the time we spent with our families, and we've actually learned to live with them and how to, it's that work-life balance that people have been talking about for a long time. Well, the pandemic did it. It brought the work-life balance, and we see families with kids at home, raising the kids, and while the kids are at school in one room, and they are in the other room working. So this kind of a way of being with family, and also the environment, the pollution levels went down, and the rivers became cleaner. And I remember receiving messages and photographs of places in India that I visited that suddenly looked different. And so the environment did clean up, and I can see that effect, the pollution has gone down. I would go back and acknowledge and thank the people that I worked with, especially in Hollywood and in Mumbai, because I think in a rush of things, as I moved on, so many things were left behind. And I'm really bad at goodbyes. But I'm sure these people know how important they are in my life, as they're all my book. So yeah, I think that's it. I'm getting better at it. First of all, I'm not a singer, but I'm going to sing Jyoti Kalash, which is one of the most beautiful songs of our country. It gives a message of the morning time, the pristine, the morning time, the beauty. and the sunlight entering into our lives, into our heart, and how to begin the day. That's the way that I see this song. So, so I have a bad throat right now. Ghare aangan van upvan upvan karti jyoti amrit ke sinchan mangal ghat dhalke ke mangal ghat dhalke jyoti kalash chhal ज्योति कलश छलके ज्योति कलश छलके I love the gym and I really believe in healthy lifestyle, so I love cooking and creating all sorts of healthy dishes, and as well I love the outdoors. I'm a big outdoors person. So being in the US, I'm currently planning to make a breakthrough back in the movies. I'm with some amazing people and I'm learning things that I could never imagine as far as movie making, filmmaking and camera, theater, everything. So I'm really diversifying myself as well. While I'm motivating others, I'm working as a life coach. And I'm, of course, writing blogs, articles, and working on my second book. I'm also working on the craft of acting and really being in cinema and theater. So I'm very privileged to be here because I have some of the best teachers and the greatest training here in the US. And I think that I'm perfectly, you know, I'm ready for the next segment of my life. I'm a part of an incredible network of other people who are making a difference in people's lives. And this began in India when I discovered somebody by the name of Arfin Khan. And I did this, I went into the training and I went into kind of a 1 year challenge where I took this up, and this was during the COVID time period. And I got a certification to be a life coach, as well as I joined Toastmasters to work on my verbal and you know, my skills as far as speaking skills and expressing myself. And I think these skills are very important looking at where we are today and the fact that we are doing everything over technology. So these are the groups that have really pushed me in the last few years. As well, now I'm working in an academy here, which is an acting studio with professional actors and professional teachers on working and developing these skills. And this is pushing me in new ways, and I'm learning so much. And I'm always meeting people, networking, and really broadening my horizon. I am not a born leader. I think leadership was inculcated to me through my various experiences. My experiences taught me, and my struggles taught me. And through that, I learned that I was meant to be a leader. And we all have our down days, and we all want to go to sleep, and you know, like I do right now, and you know, get back into bed. But I've learned that pushing yourself, motivating yourself, and challenging yourself is the way in life to move forward. And now I'm doing the same for other people. So thank you for watching. I hope my stories inspired you, and I hope that you will share it with so many other people, as well as my book. I hope you go read this book because it is meant to inspire and move the society forward and taking them away from roadblocks and places where they're stuck in their life. So my book, Door to Heaven, is available on Amazon. And I hope you continue watching other inspiring stories like this on this wonderful platform. And I'm so privileged to be here today with sharing my story with all of you. I wish all of you best of luck.
दोस्तों, आप सुन रहे थे एक एक्ट्रेस, ऑथर, क्लासिकल डांसर एंड कोरियोग्राफर आस्था दीक्षित की कहानी इनकी अपनी जुबानी। ऐसी ही प्रेरक एवं रोचक कहानियाँ रोजाना सुनने के लिए हमारा चैनल सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन जरूर दबाएं। अगर आज की ये कहानी आपको पसंद आई है तो इसे लाइक, कमेंट और शेयर करना ना भूलें। अब आप भी बन जाइए भारत की प्रोफेशनल कम्युनिटी की आवाज़। और सुनाओ अपनी कहानी, बनाओ अपनी पहचान की इस मुहिम से जुड़ गए। अपने जीवन के अनुभवों, करियर यात्रा, अपने उत्पादों एवं सेवाओं के पीछे की वास्तविक कहानी से देशवासियों को प्रेरित करें और अपनी एक नई पहचान बनाएं। टेल योर स्टोरी, इंस्पायर एंड बिल्ड योर ब्रांड विद द पावर ऑफ वीडियो। जय हिंद, जय भारत।